Well, good afternoon and welcome to Italy and back to this channel. It's been a long time, no bike adventures for obvious reasons, but summer 2021 is here and we're back on the bike. Belen is with me. We have our two Diverge Evos ready with the bikepacking setups. And I'm sorry for the noise, we're just by the main road. This is the start of an exciting loop that we are going to cycle here. The first route of this summer. And it's called the Asiago Loop. So, as you can see, it has a nice little logo, just like the Wolf's Lair. This is on bikepacking.com. And it has a nice little story attached, and I'll link it down in the description so you can check it out. We're gonna ride it, and we're gonna see if we can share it as best as possible with you, so that when you're planning your summer rides for 2021, you can take inspiration from this. Just a very important note, this is partly made possible by Komoot. We've become ambassadors for them, and we're so grateful for their support during this summer, so thanks. And of course, we're shooting on Olympus cameras. They are part of the team too, and specialized with the bikes, helmets, etc. etc. And of course, Belen is sponsored too. She's sponsored by me, I'm sponsored by her. Yeah. It's good to be a team again. If you've seen the last Italy episodes in November, cold and lonely Tristan in the mountains, that is now in the past.
Yeah, I received the emergency call, so I came this time.
Yeah. So, what do you think? Should we start riding?
Yeah.
Get away from the cars. So a couple of things that went missing in the introduction of this video. First of all, we started in Milan today and took trains to Tiene, which is a station close to the Asiago plateau. And there's quite a few ways to get to the route, but we chose to cycle from Tiene up to the pass that you're seeing now. So it's basically out of town, doing a lot of hairpin bends on a busy road until you eventually get to the route. And we have an interrail pass for those trains activated. It's for a month and we'll get back on that. But basically we had quite a late start at 5:30 today. It's why we arrived quite late at this place, and I mean, it's just a gem. It's the first camp spot of the trip, and I'm sure there's gonna be many more beautiful ones. So we're gonna put up the tent, get cooking. We switched from gasoline to alcohol-based cooking, so that's gonna be an adventure. First time in a late evening. And yeah, once again, welcome to this route. I hope you'll enjoy the footage that is to come.
Fortunately. Thank you.
goes a bit too far, this fencing. You think about it, you're like riding down, you're riding into this. Oof. So I just hit a rock, and as you can see, it came in here, and it also split my tire there. So it basically just pinched straight through, and I have to patch two holes. Wow. Never had that, ever. Double-sided. So we just cruised into Asiago, which is the start and end point of the Asiago loop route. But since we started already yesterday, we're just passing through, having a quick dinner at, I think it's called Tata Pizzeria. It's behind the co-op, it's recommendable. And we did some groceries because the next couple of days are gonna be really remote. It's a remote tour. You're mostly in the mountains, mostly dependent on little farmhouses and whatever they have to offer you. So anyway, time to stock up and go back into the mountains to find a camp spot in a few minutes. I guess you wanna pour me some and I'll cheer. Let's do it.
There we go. Cheers.
Thank you.
how much you usually have?
No, not really. And seeing that I'm quite hungry, I'm gonna put...
Oh well. They become mushy.
Yeah.
So far, I think I'm happy with the new cooking setup.
Yeah, it's so relaxed.
It's so relaxed.
So we're currently hiding under a tree. And it's day 2.5, and yeah, as you can see, it's raining. This is the weather forecast for today. It's all rain, on and off, and it's kind of yes or no. It's a bit tricky, so we're just gonna continue. It's a big climb out of Asiago that we're doing now, and it's the first, I think, of two mega climbs on this this route. As we get further into the mountains.
We're already halfway there.
Yes! It's what? 3 o'clock?
30?
It's 2:15.
Okay.
We have to stop looking for good lunch places.
Yeah.
Just settle down. This is it. We got rained on yesterday, got a ton of rain from 2 in the afternoon until about 10 in the evening. Everything soaked, and the worst thing with all that wetness is that we're running out of water. Bikepacking.com, they stated on the website for this route that it's a karstic plateau, a lot of limestone, no springs, no basically no water, so you're dependent on these things, and the question is if they work.
No.
This one seems to. Kinda. It's gonna take a while.
Yo, I'm so happy this one works.
Ooh, it's hot.
It's really handy, this handle thing.
Yeah, super handy.
Did you make extra oats?
Yes. Just stopped for a little lunch break, and we cook for lunches because there's malgas on the way. It's like kind of farmer restaurant, but I don't eat any dairy or meat or fish or anything, and Belen kind of follows along. So we don't stop at the malgas, and that means that we have to carry a lot of food, and we have to cook and make lunches because things like bread, it's also very difficult to come by. And so, well, we're just pondering about the bikepacking details because it says it takes three days. But what do you need?
Yeah, we think it's 3 days if you are in good shape, if you're not carrying barely any luggage, and if you have a good mountain bike, like thick tires, good suspension, then I guess you could do it in 3 days, yeah.
Yeah.
But that's not us.
No, so between carrying all the food and carrying a lot of water, actually, we're carrying a whole water bag, with probably 6 liters in there because the water is really scarce on this plateau. Yeah, it just makes the whole timeline go out like that. We're for sure gonna spend 6 or 7 days on this trail.
Yeah.
Hey, that's a good thing because it means there's 2 parts of this video series. How nice is that?
Wow. Damn, what a meal.
What are we snacking on?
Vegan stick. They're very good, huh? They're from the Germany. Vegan stick. I want my zip. They're so good. Very well made.
No, don't come to the camera.